get on bitches day. Ooh, I be uncaught when the fuck you took off.
Talking down about me, you a fan, ho. Crazy car snitches ass. I can't name one nigga that.
What's good, y'all? I'm back at it again. It's your girl G Baby, and welcome to the first episode of Real Bitch Radio. Now this segment, first of all, let me just tell you what we're supposed to be this week. We were supposed to go to see Glorilla. Me and my best friend, we were going to go see her in concert. But because we're in Dallas, we had some inclement weather problems. But needless to say, she postponed it, so y'all just stay tuned for that vlog. That one's gonna go crazy. But I still needed to drop something on Friday, because every Friday we're gonna be dropping something. So if you're subscribed, make sure you turn on your notifications just so you can always stay up to date with the drop. But I still wanted to do something like with music, y'all. Let me just tell y'all right now, do not mind this fucking fire alarm, okay? I've changed it. It's still beeping. If I gotta deal with it, y'all gotta deal with it. So that's just what's gonna be until somebody actually fixes it. But that's not here or there. But yeah, the episode of this is called Real Bitch Radio, where I'm gonna be reviewing new music that dropped or music that I haven't heard before, or, you know, just giving a spotlight to some up-and-coming artists that I find on Instagram or social media that I feel like deserve a spotlight shout-out and everything like that. So that's what this episode and every other episode after this is gonna be like. So first things first, we're gonna go through two songs that I heard about on Instagram like last week or this week, you know, whatever. And we're just gonna see if they're like a bump or a dump, because I'm really like a good DJ, you know, like a good car DJ. So like, if I'm in your car, best believe we're gonna be bumping to some shit. Okay? And I got something for everybody that's not country or rock, or we don't do that in my car. Fuck them. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with the first one. I'm also include the clip, but I'm viewing this on my trusty handy dandy iPad, and we'll just add a little clip it's later, and I'll add the little video up on the screen for y'all too. But the first one that we're gonna be reviewing is gonna be Detronada, Just Wanna Rock. It's supposed to be a play on Lil Uzi, I Just Wanna Rock. So I kinda am interested in what this is gonna be like, because I've been following Detronada for a little minute, ever since the Rap Game when I first saw her. But honestly, in my opinion, she should be bigger now than what she is right now, but who knows what's been going on. But let's just go ahead and see what she's talking about in Just Wanna Rock. Yeah, we're just gonna critique or whatever, dance to it or whatever, however we feel. But let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so we got ads. Let me turn this up. Okay, never mind.
Damn, really live with a rap, talk that shit so much. I'm checking in with probation. Bitch, I hate it. I don't wanna talk shit. Oh, you forever. I hope there's some things I can't fuck you. Way too late now. Okay. We can't be dead if you play my face. Bitch, talking to me, better be talking private. Free my niggas, we was running from knockers. Really living better. Watch how you pop it. I pop G lock and drop it. GBDS up and by myself. I'm not just this, just stop it. He look how my bed is. Just walk up and
come and top it.
I love a nigga with bad cash. Keep it getting a bad pay. I got shit on whoever trying to doubt me. To be honest, I'm past that.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I might have to put this down to start, you know. Okay.
Not a world,
bitch. Oh, that's it? Oh, this thing was like a minute 55 seconds long. I fuck with that. I really do. I really don't have any critiques about it or anything like that. Besides, maybe I wish it was longer than a minute 55. But I get like some artists just want to drop a little, oh, yeah, I can still rap. I can still do a little something here. But that song, I probably would have pushed it to like 2 minutes and 30 seconds. But, you know, it was still a good song. I still, you know, rock with it. It made me want to be like, like all that shit. But, yeah, I really don't have any problems with that at all. So, I would bump it in the car. It's a bump to me. What y'all think in the comments? If it's a bump or a dump to you, let me know what you think. But I would bump it. Maybe not be the first thing that I bump, but I would, you know. All right, so I was so excited to do this song because I saw a clip it, whatever y'all want to call it. I saw it on Instagram, but I cannot talk now, I'm sorry. Immediately, I was like, I have to review it. This song might be the one to make me twerk. Y'all might see a little ass moving. That's why I'm wearing some, you know, low ass shorts anyway. Cause a song is good if it got me moving my hips a little bit, or it got me throwing it back. That's how you know it's a good song. Cause first of all, I love to twerk. I love to twerk. I know how to throw his ass and keep niggas entertained. But anyway, so the next song that we're gonna be reviewing or looking over my little reaction to is gonna be Gloss Up featuring K Carbon, Sly Maroney, and Aliza. Now let me tell you something about this little quartet here. I'm glad that they're here. I really am. I'm fucking with them. I'm glad that they starting to get more recognition and everything like that. They're a very good, diverse group. Like lyrical wise, you know, they're very diverse, have different styles. Even though it's like female rap, it could be the same because they all rap about the same thing, but it's always a style and a way and a flow to it, you know what I'm saying? But let's just go ahead and see what it is and see if this ass gets moving, because I honestly think it's about to. But so this is Eeny Meeny Miney Moe by Gloss Up, K Carbon, Sly Maroney, and Aliza. Fuck with this video. It's so hard. Oh, cool. Oh, okay. See, here it comes. Yeah. Yeah. See, this video is just so simple, and that's all it needs. I want your nigga or I want you. Nah, I'll stick with you. Let me not. Ride you like a sled, nigga. I can't stop. It just keeps. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's the one. That's the one. That's definitely a bump. Definitely a bump. But what I really like about what they're doing is how they're taking like things from our childhood. Cause like Shibuya, masterpiece. This shit, masterpiece. It's gonna go up just like Shibuya. I promise you. I promise you. I don't feel like y'all really saw my ass moving like that. So I feel like twerking. I really do. I'm gonna play this shit again because I really fucked with it. So I really did. So let's go ahead and run that shit all the way back. Yeah. Like, see, fun fact about me, I could twerk for the whole song. I really could. And there's proof of that. Ask one of my best friends. I could twerk for the whole song. Baby got an ass on her. The fuck? Yeah. Yeah, that's my next Baptist song. I'm not even going to cap to you. Like I said, I could twerk for the whole song if I really wanted to. I was just really trying to keep my composure at the same time. But that's one of those songs that would do something if I heard it in the club. Immediately, ass would be moving, like, immediately. But appreciate Glossop, Slamaroni, K Carbon, and Aliza for show for that. That right there is the one. That one deserves a replay for sure. All right, so last but not least, it's gonna be our spotlight talent. I did some research on Instagram and I wanted to see who's the up and coming artist and who is actually doing their shit right now. And I actually came across this one artist. His name is Aaron Elijah. If you wanna follow him, his at name is I Am Aaron Elijah. And so y'all make sure y'all go show love and support. But he wanted me to review what he called Flashback. Okay, it's on Apple Music. Just look up Aaron Elijah on Apple Music. And it's called Flashback. The first thing that I would say, bro, as I'm looking at this at a quick glance, is because like you need to change your title. Your title is saying flashback single. You know, everybody's gonna think it's one song. You got two songs here. I don't know if it's supposed to be like a project and you're just adding things on there. Then gonna drop it up. Like, I don't know what you gonna do, but I wouldn't. If it's supposed to be a single, have it be one song, because two is kind of misleading and everything. But pretty sure they're both good. I would hope they're both good. You know, I'm gonna be honest if it was trash. Okay. I'm be honest, okay? But since you got two songs on here, I'm just gonna go with your most popular song, which is Crew, and let's just see what's up with that. So, okay. I'm fucking with this beat for sure. I think the song is really, really good. The only thing that I could say is that if you decide to re-record that, or, you know, whatever that you're planning to do with this project here, I would say have the engineer turn your voice up, because it's very hard to hear you and what you're saying instead of the beat. You know, like, the beat is nice and everything like that, but the staticky voice that you're having, like, it works with the song, but it just wasn't clear, you know what I'm saying? So I just think one, enunciation a little bit better, and two, just having your voice turned up over the beat, just like, it's like it's there but it's not there, because it's almost as if your voice and the beat is clashing, and that's making people like be like, have to really listen to that. You may have intended it to be that way, but I'm just saying, to make it better, I think that would be what you would have to do, you know. But overall, I think it's a bump. I would definitely bump that shit, not gonna lie. But, you know, like I said, as musically, that's my opinion. But, you know, I don't know what you was really planning to do with that track anyway. So, but that's just what I say that you should do. But that concludes episode one of Real Bitch Radio. Thank you so much for taking the time out to watch it and review things with me. If you want to leave your own critiques or your own comments, go right ahead and leave those down below. I'm going to include the links to everything, which I mean, you should be able to find it based off of me mentioning it. But just in case you can't, it will be listed in the bio. I would like to say a special thank you again to Aaron Elijah for blessing us with that content right there and allowing me to critique it with my own honest opinions and thoughts. All of these songs I have not listened to previously before this. I have not done anything of that sort. So this is my raw reactions to it. But thank y'all so much for viewing this video again, for sure. If you haven't seen the last video last Friday, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe, and also follow me on my socials, which will also be on the next slide. But yeah, this has been a very successful. I cannot talk today. I need to lay down. I don't know what's going on with me, but my lips and my words have been all over the place. But it's okay. We just gonna do what we gonna do to edit and everything like that. But yes, go ahead and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. If you fuck with it, go ahead and share it with your friends and everything like that. And just come fuck with the winning team. Come fuck with us, because there's a whole lot more coming. A whole lot.